Hi, man, out here on a hot Sunday afternoon. Hopefully tomorrow it won't be as hot and humid, but been working on the boat, getting it ready to take out. Tomorrow's my Monday off, getting it all ready to take it out. Just wanted to go over some of the new changes I've made to it, or new updates I've made to it. So let's take a look at those. All right, first off, up front, I added this pull handle. So hopefully it'll be easier to pull this heavy thing that way instead of this way. Give me some leeway around and whatever. This is a power stick. It's a Ulanzi, a 10,000 milliamp hour. So that should last all day. Just used some quick release attachments that I already had. And that's my front GoPro. And it's just a quick release. So then it's off, good to go. And I got me a new case to carry my GoPros in. Wanted to show you, I'm waiting for them to get them back in. Native makes a bucket that fits in here. And that way I can store stuff up here. Right now I don't want to store anything in there because, man, it'll just slide all the way to the back. You know what I'm saying? I put stuff in there and it just slid. But anyway, I wanted to show you the battery box that I put in. And it's just a quick release that I already showed you there. Quick release, quick connect that I already showed you. With this, you just plug it in and the fish finder is powered and good to go. Finally got the right size vest in. Got my phone holder in there. Got my whistle here. I got a knife on the way. For the GoPros, remote control. It works on both of them at the same time. I've tested it and it's freaking awesome. I hope it works when I get out on the water. It's got it Velcroed here. I've got both cameras set to the 5 minute loop. So, you know, once it gets to 5 minutes, it just keeps recording. An extra minute deletes the first minute of the five. Anyway, look it up on YouTube. It works good. Should work great for capturing the catch to release. That shouldn't take more than hopefully 5 minutes unless I get a freaking 12 pound or something and it takes me 10 minutes to get it in the boat. Then we'll see what happens. But anyway, on the seat, I just added these Velcro straps to the extra flap so it's not in the way, out of the way when I reach down to get stuff. For the landing gear, when it's stowed away while I'm on the water, just some safety clips to keep them from falling out. All right, this pack came with the boat. They had it sitting the other way, and all the rails were all on one side. There was seven of them on one side. So I reconfigured it, got these new end caps for the rails, make it look kind of factory. Got these at an angle, don't know why. Looks like that's my six cylinder in there, man. Good to go. It'll hold seven of these, which is more than I'll ever need. Got a new cooler, $15 cooler from Walmart, plastic lined. It's got a zipper pouch on the front and on both sides. It's got two nets, but I don't need them. All right, so the seventh one I put here, of course, did the old PVC pipe. And I haven't taped this in yet. That's the audio cable. I wanted to test it before I taped it in. It's removable. It just slips down in. I can change the angle if I want to, but I think for now it'll just stay in the back. Here's my other GoPro. Got the audio and the power coming from it, coming down. The power bank right there is a solar powered. I paid $25 for it. Just got it Velcroed in. It's also got built-in LED lights, flashlights. Pretty neat little thing, and it's just Velcroed in right here so I can take it out to charge it. On the other side, piece of Velcro here, which is for the Rode wireless, which I'm using right now on this camera. The receiver just Velcros right there. Audio cable plugs into it, and we're good to go. I've got on order the Yak Attack, even though I watch Yak Pack. The Yak Attack double header mount thing so I can have my paddle put together for launching, store it right here, you know, ready, waiting, you know, so if I need it. Last time I went out, I could see the advantage of having a paddle handy for helping staying stationary. With the pedal drive, you know, forward, backward, but as far as left to right mobility and just trying to keep it pointed in a certain way, I can see the advantage of having the paddle handy. I've got the Forever Last, I think that's what it's called, the one that all the kayak guys are using, net. I've got that coming, gonna do the modification to it to add a longer handle to it so I can keep it. It'll just be on the deck and rest right here. Getting up in the morning and heading out to Lake Monroe, down to Monroe. Hopefully catch a fish this time. Gonna make sure I take my ultralight setup so the bass aren't biting, or if I just suck like I always do and can't hook a bass, maybe I can catch a bream and get my first fish in the boat. Yeah, man, that's it. Like, subscribe, share. And hopefully you've seen something on this that, you know, maybe you haven't thought of, or, but man, most all these ideas I got from watching YouTube videos anyway. So it's all been done before, but just wanted to show you where I was at. And that's it, man. We will catch you on the water tomorrow.